check it out, guys. We are back with a brand new episode on the channel. We are back on the Town Hall 12 account, and we're going to be doing something super fun here today, guys. Now, just a quick side note, I've actually maxed out so much of this base. I'm going to make a prediction, guys. I reckon we're going to be completely maxed out before the end of this month. That means we've got like 21 days or something. All we really need to do is walls and cannons now, guys. But fingers crossed we're going to be able to max out this entire base by the end of May. Make sure you are subscribing to the channel, guys. We are posting 2 COC videos every single day. It's going to be awesome to see what happens once we max out this base. Will there be another update this summer? All that aside, though, let's focus on today's episode, guys. If you've been subbed to the channel for at least one day, you will know yesterday we maxed out our final upgrade inside of the lab, guys. We got ourselves level 9 Hog Riders. That means we've got every single troop and spell, Dark Elixir and Elixir, and all the siege machines are now 100% maxed out, guys. And in order to celebrate this, we're going to do something crazy right now in this episode. Check this out. If I go over to my army camps, guys, and we click the info button, we have got one of every single troop in the game, from Barbarian all the way to the Electro Dragon, guys. We got one of every single troop, but we do have 4 wall breakers, and we also have 4 healers. They are, of course, to fill the rest of the troop capacity. What we're going to be doing, it's going to be scary, but it's definitely going to be fun, guys. We're about to get ourselves into a live attack against the top player on the enemy team, guys. Our recommended target, we're number one. We're going to take them on. Now, usually, I wouldn't do this, guys, but because we're losing by over 30 war stars and we've done more than 10 attacks, it is now impossible for us to win this war. So instead of just doing a boring attack, we're going to have some serious fun. We're about to use every single troop on this guy. The question is, can we take him down, guys? Can we get a 1-star? Can we get a 2-star? Can we complete a miracle and get a 3-star? Take your guesses. Now, just before we do this, guys, I've got a side note to show you. Check this out. Now, this is a 50 against 50. This is my new clan, GT Resurrection. I did make it a couple of days ago, guys. If you do want to join the clan, make sure you do bookmark it. And leave a like on the video if you want me to make a new account and maybe create another clan. But check this out. If I go to the bottom players on my team, for the first time ever, I've never seen Town Hall level 3s, or for at least a year, guys. I haven't seen Town Hall level 3s inside of Clan War. And when I was looking at these dudes' bases, I was thinking, what kind of attack strategies do these guys actually use? So let's go ahead and check this out, guys. Before I get into a live attack, let's see what they've done with their attack. So, this guy has actually used both his attacks, guys, and he took on number 49 and number 50 on their team. So let's go ahead and see what actual strategy he used to destroy these bases, guys. Now, I've actually got to go and head into the war stats, guys, because we need to look for Mr. Hunt. So let's do this. Let's go to my team and let's look for Mr. Hunt. He's all the way down at the bottom, guys. Here we go. We are going to watch his replay against... Let's watch his replay against number 49, guys, which is attack number 2. Check this out. Shout out to Mr. Hunt, by the way. So, this is the attack strategy a Town Hall level 3 uses inside of Clan Wars, guys. Barbarians, archers, giants, and, of course, one wall breaker. A single wall breaker, but it's almost impossible. It is literally impossible for this dude to get a 1-star. Especially when you got max balloons, max archers, and a Valkyrie inside of the defending CC, guys. Literally impossible, but it's still definitely awesome to see. So let's do this, guys. Let's head into our live attack. Okay, by the way, I've got some troops in my clan castle. I got level 1 bowlers and a Valkyrie, and we got a rage spell. So they should help out. They should help out. We still have 1 spell place left. Let's get another free spell. Okay, so in order to make this as insane as possible, we're not even going to make a strategy, guys. We're going to go straight into the live attack. So let's do this. Take your guesses. 1-star, 2-star, 3-star. Here we go. Okay. First thing I want to do is make sure my Grand Warden is set to ground, guys. I'm actually really nervous. I am really nervous, but I'm gonna try and do as much damage as possible with the Queen, and hopefully she's gonna get, you know, a decent amount of damage done to this base. Now, I think I've got a good strategy. So I'm gonna use a baby dragon before I actually use the Queen, guys, just to kind of test for any air mines or air bombs. I'm also gonna drop a balloon here, also to test, guys. And now we're gonna go in with this Queen. The four healers just behind. And I am gonna do a very quick move with this rage spell, guys. I would like to use just two of the wall breakers to try and get the Queen to enter. And then I'm going to use the giant to distract. Hopefully it's going to get the Queen to go in, guys. Here we go. Queen is distracted. The wizard tower. And now we're entering in. So I want to enter into this hole here. Try and take out the Eagle Artillery, guys. Here comes the defending CC. We didn't bring a poison spell, but it's cool. It's just a dragon. Well, in fact, it's two dragons, but it shouldn't be an issue, guys. There goes the first one. And there goes the second one. Okay, the Queen's looking good. Let's start to make a funnel somewhere else, guys. Where are we going to funnel? I actually have no idea, but I've got to move quickly because my Queen's about to get in trouble. So, let's do this. I'm going to drop an Ice Golem down here. Golem on the other side. And I'm going to drop in the heroes, guys. We're going to slowly dab all these troops in. And I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to keep some of the air troops back, guys. So I'm not going to use everything. Let's drop in the barbarians and the archers. Check up on the archer queen. She is looking good. Here we go. Troops are coming in. There goes our rage spell, guys. I'm going to use the queen's ability. I'm going to drop a free spell on the defending heroes, guys. And we are slowly making our way into the base. So as this is going in, here comes the rest of our troops, guys. So electro dragon's down. The queen has been killed. I need to try and save the poor healers, guys. So let's drop those freeze spells down. I'm going to use another freeze. And we are somehow making our way into the core of the base now. There goes the Grand Warden's ability, guys. Question is, can we take out this actual Giga Tesla? Let's see. The P.E.K.K.A. is going into the center. The King's there as well. We done it. We got the Giga Tesla down. And we're up to 71% damage, guys. This is insane. Still 44 seconds left in the battle. Still got healers. Still got an Electro Dragon. I'm actually in shock. We have done an insane amount of damage to this base. And we used every single troop in the game. So I'm going to try and save as many of my troops here, guys, by using the King's ability. Unfortunately, we just don't have any wall breakers. We are through, though. And we're literally closing in on a triple star. This is absurd. Can the P.E.K.K.A. take out the Inferno Tower? Yes, it can. Oh my, guys. If we had like 20 more seconds, we would have literally triple starred a Town Hall level 12 using every single troop in the game. 93% two star. That's actually pretty damn incredible. Take a look at all those troops at the bottom of the screen, guys. From the baby dragon to that rage spell. How many in total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30. 32 different troops, spells, heroes, and siege machines used. And we got a 93% 2-star. That's just incredible. By the way, guys, I did see there was a note left on this base. And, oh no, someone said this, yours, Tony. Okay, shout out to whoever done that, guys. Obviously, we still have a second attack to use. And I don't think I'm going to use every single troop in the game now because we already done that. It was fun. But I think I'm probably just going to do a quick triple star on number 3 or something like that, guys, just to get some extra war stars in there. And obviously, we are most likely going to lose, but you want to keep the morale in your clan high. So please, always make sure you use your war attacks, guys. Now, what we're going to do, we are going to continue with our balloon blitz. We've done 9 out of 40, guys. That means we need to train up some more balloon armies. So I'm going to go for army number 2, of course. I do need some siege machines, and I'm going to boost that barrack, actually, the siege workshop. Let's train a couple of them up, guys. Before we end this episode, let's do some upgrades inside of the base. So, I did keep a single builder free, guys. We're upgrading a mortar and 3 Archer Towers. But before we end the episode, I think we've got enough loot to upgrade 2 walls, guys. Let's see. Okay, maybe not 2, just 1. So, 4.5 million elixir on a level 13 wall, and we almost have enough gold to do another one, guys, but not just yet. Do we have any loot in the treasury? No, we do not, guys. We're going to be ending this episode here. Please remember, we are doing double uploads here on the YouTube channel, guys. Subscribe, leave a like, turn on those post notifications, and stay tuned for the next one.